Well, hello once again.
I'm Jeremy Elliott.
And I'm Matt Wright.
Hi.
Well, we're just going to roll with some stuff today, and we have a lot to do, but we're going to start with the spiritually oriented thing.
All right. Today I was talking to Jesus Christ, and for the most part of the morning, led me into a conversation with the Buddha. You know, but I want to say that the vibes of Jesus Christ are here today, and I don't want to get the church involved in this or thinking of me negatively or in any which way, shape, or form. But Jesus is with us just like anyone else.
You know, just like any other spirit.
That's right.
He's just coming on through. Mm-hmm. And you all can reach them like that too. You know, you don't have to be down on your knees praying and prostrating. You know, just think some thoughts and they'll be there with you. You know,
Jesus will connect with you easily, you know.
Oh, yeah.
He's been with me all day. I wanted to say that I've been going through a rough time myself, you know. So, and I was in the hospital recently for it. And I just want to put that out there to know that all people are human, you know. Everybody has and makes mistakes. But Jesus is helping, and the Buddha put on my Mani Padme Hum beads, which means Buddha, the lotus, and the jewel. But anyway, let's get to business.
Let's get down to it.
Alright.
Well, look, Tears, I want to let you know, you'd speak, you know, you already know what I'm thinking, you know what people watching this are going to think, you know, speak some words of wisdom, or whatever you know.
Well, Jesus is humble, he doesn't know what to say. What do you want me to say, Jesus?
Well, I don't know what you to say anything that you don't want. I mean, I just thought you might have something you might want to say since we're videotaping this and I'm going to put it up on the internet. That's why I asked that. No offense, my brother.
No.
I mean,
He has a big smile on his face. It's not like he's mad or angry.
I know.
He just meant, what do you want me to say? You know, ask me a question. I'm a human, too. You know?
Well, let me see. Yeah. Well, I mean,
listen, he says, okay, I see what you're getting at now. All right.
He's already answered it before I asked it.
But we're talking, you know, spiritualness. People want to hear from him what, you know, the words of wisdom that, you know, he's expected to kick those kind of vibes, you know what I mean? So he knows that's what we want in a sense already. But what he's trying to say is that, you know, we are all one and alike, you know. So, you know, credit Jesus, you know, I'm saying credit Jesus to what he is, but he's saying credit him to only as a human being.
That's right. You know, because I don't think that, look, I don't think that you ever intended people to turn into it is, this Christian church to turn into what it is now. You know, I think you meant you did a whole different thing. Am I correct?
There's so much.
I mean, they screwed up the teachings pretty bad.
All he ever wanted to do was help people, you know, himself. He was a young boy one time. He's showing me this young image of him and growing, you know, just living a life, you know, like a thug, you know, if you want to say. He was an outcast.
Yeah.
You know? And then when he started helping people out, people noticed this, you know. Now when we, you know, go into a Christian church, we expect to give money to a plate and stuff like this. Mm. We expect to listen to words of him. But these are hardly the words of a man that, you know, is just a normal man.
That's right.
Just a regular man. He's saying, help me know what to say. He's humble. He's saying, help me know what to say. You know.
That's how we try to be. I try to be as humble as I can. Sometimes I fail at that, but I
have mad respect for Jesus. Yeah. I have a hard time asking him to say anything.
Yeah.
But it's our
work in this world. You know, you set a good example, you know, like, because we're outcasts too in this world, Jesus. Look, you know, I know I'm an outcast, so is Jeremy, you know, and then we're here to help outcasts, people that the world, this kind of other society throws away, you know. That's what I want to do.
You know what happened to me.
Yep.
Okay. He said, beware of that, you know. But the thing is, as long as you tell the truth and be honest and humble and best of your ability, you're okay.
Yeah, because look, if we have to, if what happens to you happens to us in a way, I mean, fine. You know, look, I mean, if I'm trying to get to that point where I kind of accept that.
It happens every day.
You know,
to people just like him.
You know, because people don't want to hear it. You know, they don't want, a lot of people don't want to hear this. A lot of people get mad when people give a damn about people who get or who the outcast. You know what I'm saying? Like, because you're bucking society.
That's what he bucked society. That's what he said. That's what I did.
You did.
I bucked society. He repeated the words. But, because I don't think he even spoke those words before in his life.
That's just the word that popped in my head, bucks, because it's like bucking that.
You know what I mean.
Yeah. And so
he says, of course I do, you know.
Because that's what we do. All my life, I wanted to buck society. This society is messed up. It's screwed up. You know, things are messed up.
From the get-go, Jesus is not white. You know, if anything...
Tell him what he looks like.
You know, like his skin color is like a tannish grayish.
Go ahead, keep going. I apologize. I forgot to turn this off.
It's a tannish grayish. He's just, maybe...
Should we answer this phone call, Jesus? Like, this is somebody, maybe...
Go for it.
All right. Keep on going. Keep on going.
Okay.
Hello?
Well...
Hey, we're channeling Jesus right now, you know, right as we speak. He came through to talk to us about, like, if you have, like, I want to put you on this, man. Like, do you have anything to say? I mean, he's right here, right? We're recording it right now, so, I mean, he's sitting right here in the room. So, yeah, I asked him if I should answer the phone, and he said, all right, go ahead. So, look, man. Talk to him. He's not like what you think he is. He's more like you, somebody you might hang out on the street, just hanging out with people. You know? So, go ahead, brother. You know? Yeah, yeah. Yep. Yeah, do you want me to put you on speakerphone so you can talk to him, man? I want you to throw you in the conversation. I think it would help you. Do you want to listen? We can watch the tape. Or do you want to, would you rather listen to it as it happens? I'm sorry.
Yeah, put him right. All right.
I'm going to put it on speakerphone, okay? And just stay in the background, okay? Of course. I mean, I didn't say your name, brother. All right. Hold on. He's worried about.
That's okay.
He knows what we're thinking.
No words be spoken. No names.
Okay, are you still there? It's a speakerphone now. Just say yes if you can hear me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Can you hear me? Can you hear us all right now? Okay.
All right, here we go.
Let's go. All right.
Sorry, go.
Okay.
Well, he looks more like, I'm trying to explain what Jesus looks like. He's not white. He's more like a tan skin, wide nose a little bit, and his hair is very thick. You know, it's hard to comb. If you could, you know what I'm trying to say.
Kind of like dreads, like head, you know, like
his hair hasn't been combed. You know, I mean, lucky. You know what I mean? It would be lucky if he got combed, but you know, maybe that's the best way to describe him.
More Middle Eastern looking, maybe a little bit more Arab looking.
That's what I was going to say.
That's what I was feeling.
Arabic. You know, I can't say that word.
Now, I can see how, like, the church has tried to depict Jesus as white because they want to manipulate people. You know, and, like, I don't know why. You know, it's a racist thing.
He stepped in at this point.
Okay, I don't know.
No, it doesn't matter what they depict him as. You know, which color, it doesn't matter. He said that, you know.
Yeah, because some people depict him as black, and then some people, you know what I mean? Right. I understand.
Yeah.
But
keep going.
But, look, you know, we got a third person here, and Jesus, you know what I'm saying? You know, like, if you have anything to say to him, say it. You know, I don't know if you want, but, you know, you can, I want to help everybody out, let you get a chance to do whatever, because you can read his mind and all of that, too, so.
Any questions, anything I think he's willing to answer right now?
All right. Listen,
Let's keep going.
You know, but... You know what we want to do? I'm sorry, I lost my focus.
The words are, like, you know, like I said before, you know, he knows that people are trying to expect him to kick some kind of wisdom.
Yeah.
You know, but the thing is, the wisdom is not really what he does. I mean, he was just more like you and me.
A friend.
And everyone involved here, you know, just like us, you know, helping people the best he could. You know, without a doubt, he did the best he could.
Oh, of course.
That's it.
Of course. That's what it's all about, because, like, compassion, friends, understanding. You have to understand people to be compassionate. You know what I'm saying?